Guys, welcome to BBD Bobbity Toys, and today we're gonna be unboxing the Rapunzel doll. Here I have some trees because I just wanted, you know, the decorations to be like Christmas vibes because we're in the Christmas season. Anyways, we're gonna be unboxing the Rapunzel doll along with her fashion pack right here. We're gonna go into details after unboxing the doll, so we can try it on her and all those kind of stuff. So here's the doll. I got it at Shop Disney for $19.99, and in Canadian dollars is $27.99. There's a new packaging for the doll. It used to be like this plastic packaging, but now it's full cardboard and reusable. So after, you can put your doll back in the box like it was before. I'm just gonna talk about the front of the box, then we'll go at the back. Front of the box, there is an illustration of Rapunzel, and it's written Princess Rapunzel, doll brush included, Disney, and all those kind of stuff. At the back of the box, there is a picture of a scene of when Rapunzel was singing, and at last I see the lights. I'm gonna insert a clip here so you guys can remember. She's here, suddenly I know if she's okay here. So at the back of the box, that's basically it. There's an illustration of the castle, Rapunzel, the castle, Rapunzel, the tower. It says plastic free packaging and some other stuff, and the price right here. So that's basically what's on the box. Now let's get the doll out of the box to see what's inside. So I took the doll out of the box, and here is the box empty. It's kind of like the fireplace in the tower. I absolutely love how they decorated it. It's so pretty. Now let's see what we got in the box. This is what it came with, the doll, and the decoration kind of looks like when Rapunzel, when she would look outside the window, like outside the tower. That's how it looks like. It's really, really pretty. I love the decoration, the packaging, everything. It's so good and amazing. Now to open it, so you just lift this up, open, pull the doll out, and here is the doll out of the box. She's not wearing shoes. When you remove the doll out of the box, you will have this like little background. It's also the fireplace. It's like inside the castle. That's how it looks like, and I love it. And also here is the doll brush. We're gonna talk about that after. Now let's talk about the doll.
And sweep till the floor's all clean. Polish and wax, do laundry and mop and shine up.
So here's Rapunzel. We're gonna talk about her face, her outfit, and everything about the doll. So let's start with her face. For Rapunzel's face, she has big green eyes, and she's looking to the side, not straight. She's kind of looking up, and she has pinkish purplish eyeshadow. She has eyelashes. She also has freckles over her cheeks. She has pink blush, and she has pink lips. She also has like a flower in her head. There we go. And that's all for her face. She is really pretty. I love how they made her. Now let's talk about her outfit. For Rapunzel's dress, she's wearing a long dress with puff sleeves and a lace detailing on the dress. She's also, at the bottom of the dress, there is like glittery parting all over, and is an overlay, is a mesh overlay, so you can lift it up and see another material under the dress. So her dress, so simple, just like what we saw in the movie, and I love it. Look at those designs on it. It's glittery and everything. So for Rapunzel's feet, she is not wearing shoes. I think it's pretty good because in the movie she wasn't wearing shoes, so it'd be like dumb to just give her shoes when in the movie she's not. So it's pretty accurate not to like give her shoes. Now let's talk about her hair. So for her hair, they kind of like put elastics on it so it doesn't get everywhere. So I'm gonna just snip them out and show you.
So I snipped the little elastic things out, and here she is. Her hair is super soft, no product in it.
It's also really long, just there, really, really long. And her hair is light, like you can even see the bald part of her hair. So it's like really, really light, unlike the others. So you can just see everything going on there. And for the front part, they've inserted the flower there, and they kind of like took a piece of hair and tied it up for like the little hairstyle there. So that's pretty much it for Rapunzel. I love her so much, but I think they could have done better on the hair. It's really, really light. And the fact that I can see her bald head, it's, yeah. I love it though. I love Rapunzel. She's one of my favorite Disney princesses. It's a really good doll. Rapunzel is articulated at the arm, elbow, wrist. She can move her wrist. She can also move her head sideways, so it's movable. And for her feet, they are not articulated at all, but you can snap her feet, kinda. But for her feet, legs, not articulated. So now let's unbox the fashion pack. The fashion pack comes in a plastic packaging. It's written Princess Rapunzel accessory pack at the back. It's pretty much like the box, Rapunzel's box, and the same thing. It says Princess Rapunzel, and it comes with a dress, a crown, a scarf, a frying pan, but it fell. So I'm gonna take it out and show you guys. Two like flower hair clips and shoes. So it comes with shoes for Rapunzel. Now let's take it out of the box for a closer look.
Here's everything out of the box. Now let's put it on Rapunzel and kind of like compare the two outfits.
Okay guys, so while dressing her up, I thought it would be better to show you guys her articulation. So as you can see, no articulation, but she can do the split and bend her legs to get up. So her legs are movable. For her knees, I found out that it snaps, it kind of bends, and you can do that. For her feet, nothing but flat feet. Now I'm just gonna put her in the outfit.
It's puzzles and darts and
things. Hey guys, here is Rapunzel in her second outfit from the fashion pack. She's wearing a glittering satin dress with puff sleeves, a gold glitter edging at collar, and some on her skirt. There are some suns on the skirt, like lanterns, suns around the outfit. There's also some flowers on the front panel, some floral print, and there's a gold slitter rickrack trim right here. It also comes with a coordinating shawl
which has the sun print and floral print on it. And it also has that little glitter trim right here. I didn't put it on her neck because it kept falling off. So I'm just gonna put it on the side just like that. And she also came with a frying pan right here, which she can hold. So we're just gonna make her hold it. Here's her holding the frying pan. And she also came with some pink flat shoes. So overall, I just don't like the second outfit, to be honest. The first outfit, the original outfit, the purple one, is way better and just original. For the second one, I think it was a little bit hard to put on because her fingers just kept entering right here. You know, those little holes. I don't know if you guys can see, but those little holes right there. Her fingers kept entering, so you need to pay attention when putting on the second dress. And the second dress is really pretty. I love it, but I just prefer the purple one than the pink one. And for me, I think instead of the doll brush, they should have included the frying pan because it just makes more sense to include the frying pan. Like for Jasmine, they could have included the lamp, for Snow White, an apple, for Belle, a book, you know, instead of a doll brush. It's just, or maybe the crown that she's wearing, instead of including it in the fashion pack, is just better. So here is the crown that it also came with a fashion pack. She also had some flower pins, but I didn't think it's necessary since she's already wearing the crown. I took the flower out of her hair right here, and as you can see, the flower is also really cheaply made. It's a material, it feels like it's tearing and everything. So the flower is a 0 out of 10 for it. It's just not it. I love her so much. I love everything.
Hi guys,
some cons and pros about this doll, the outfit, the fashion pack, and everything. So the pros are she is really beautiful. The dress looks like the original and the details, everything really pretty. Love it. Love that she's articulated and everything. Cons is the flower that I told you guys, very cheaply made. Feels like it's ripping. And also her hair, it's very, very, very light. You can see the bald places that I showed you guys earlier. So yeah, for her second outfit, it's kind of like, you can see those, the glitter also kept falling off, but you can see it's like already used, something like that. Kind of like the hairy things that come on your dress when you wash it and all that. But overall, this doll is really pretty. She's really cute. I love it so much. Just think they should have included the frying pan than including the brush.
Let's take a look at Rapunzel's brush.
She has a purple brush. It says Disney Parks. It has a, like the little castle on it. And it has a crown on top. And it brushes her hair really well, like, look. And some of the hair shedded off. So her hair is a no-no. 2 out of 10 for the hair. But it's really pretty, soft, silky, long. Really, really love her. And I hope you guys like this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys like this review. Also, like this video. Comment down below what you think about this Rapunzel doll. And also switch on your bell notifications because I'm going to be unboxing the other princesses. I already unboxed Snow White and Jasmine, so if you guys haven't seen that video, go check it out. I'm going to unbox the other princesses after. So thank you guys for watching. I love you guys so much. Mwah. Merry Christmas. Bye.